little two parts. First, what is the most exciting thing that you did not expect, like the most wonderful thing about touring all together again, and what's been like the hardest?
Well, thanks for listening. We love to hear stories like that. We've heard so many stories of mothers and daughters, sons and families. I mean, especially just like a daughter and a dad will come on a day and they you know, I was reading someone recently online on social media, and that their dad got them a t-shirt. I think they're here tonight somewhere, but you know, and the t-shirt was too big, so they slept in it, and now they're 28 and the shirt fits. And so it was awesome, and to hear them stories. And so everyone's got two questions here today, aren't they? What was the question again?
So what was the easiest thing about coming together and the hardest?
I think the most surprising thing of coming together was that it worked.
Yes.
Because we didn't know, it's a really strange concept to bring kind of two eras of the band together, and it really, really works. And and it's brought up these really great memories for all of us too, because we get to be, you know, when you're not touring together as musicians, you kind of really go your separate lives. You know, Phil was doing Zealand stuff, doing whatever I do, and these guys have been touring, so we don't get to see each other much. But the greatest thing is we've got to hang out a lot more, and you know, and just realize things like I knew Mike before I knew any of the other guys in the band besides Duncan. So Mike and I, we toured. Mike was in this little group. What are they called again?
DC Cheese.
Yes, that's it. DC Talk. So DC Talk and the Newsboys, way back in the day. Always a winner. And you know, we were touring together. So that's been. So far, that's been. I think I can find it as the hardest one, but I want to boast on a few of these guys, and that is that Duncan and Jody and Jeff. They have the hardest job tonight, because we're playing 29 songs tonight. So we're going right. You know, it's a night full of music. It's not, you know, we're not sort of standing around too much. You know, so these three of them and Phil and myself and Mike, we get to take a break. We're tag team, you know what I mean? So maybe that for them has been probably, you know, which is all. I think it's awesome, because I love bands that play a long time and play music. So we definitely have that. I'm not sure if there's been a bad downside.
It really hasn't. I mean, if there is a bad, it's the fact that we're playing 29 songs. But the good thing is we're playing 29 songs. So and I think no matter when you started listening to the band, there's going to be a song or two that you're going to resonate with. So it's a great night. Especially for the fan, it doesn't get any better.
Yeah, it's a big change since when we started out, we had to play some songs twice in the set.
That's right.
Yeah, after decent songs to fill up the night.
So. The set list would sort of start with Not Ashamed, and then about four songs and be Not Ashamed again, and then we'd end with Not Ashamed.
Your calls, Not Ashamed.
We weren't scared of playing the hits, you know. So now it's been a tough thing to pick out of a band that has a large catalogue. It's been, which songs do we play? But we really feel like we've got a good mixture of it all. And it really is strange. It goes really well together, both of them together. So it's fun. What's that box you got there?
Oh, look out.
Oh, starting already. Oh, two more. Oh, no. I love it.
Is there another smaller one inside that?
Yes. There's a cuteness award right there. Oh, the headphones. So, yeah. That looks like a little drummer, I think.
Oh, yeah. Real quick, here we go. Last question.